This is the solution to WEC-003. Okay. So we want to find the equation of the tangent line. So the equation for any line is that if we have a point on the line x0, y0, and we have the slope of the line m, then the equation of the line is given by y minus y0 is equal to m multiplied by x minus x0. So the idea for part A is that derivative gives the slope of the tangent line. So as for the point, we're told that x0, the initial input is 0, so then y0 will be the exponential of x0, which is the exponential of just 0, which is 1. So the point that we're looking for is 0, 1. And then the slope, dy dx, well, that's the derivative of the exponential, but that's just the exponential. The slope that we're looking for is you evaluate the derivative at x0. So the notation, the bar notation, means evaluate or plug in. That's the kind of notation that you use when you're not using a function like f of x. So that means that m is the exponential, that thing, of just 0, so m is 1, and therefore the equation of the line is y minus y0, so y minus 1 is equal to m, so 1 multiplied by x minus x0, which is 0, so y minus 1 is equal to just x, so y is x plus 1. So now let A be a real that's positive and not 1. Find the equation of the tangent line. Okay, so it's the same, same kind of idea. So in this case, the point, the initial input, x0, is again 0. The output there is now a to x0, which is a to 0, which is again 1. And therefore, the point that we're talking about is 0, 1. For the slope, now here's where it's slightly different. To calculate the slope of the tangent line, we need the derivative. So this will be the derivative of a to x, but because a is not the natural exponential, the derivative is not quite as nice as the natural exponential. So this will be a to x, and then multiplied by natural logarithm of a. So you can think of that, this as like the consequence so just as factually as possible, this is a consequence of the chain rule, but if you wanted to operate in base A instead of the natural base, this is the consequence of using a non-natural base. Okay, so the slope will be the derivative evaluated at x is x0. So that means that we need to plug in 0 into that expression. So this will be a to 0 multiplied by the logarithm of a. Notice that that didn't change because we're plugging in for x, not for a. A is just some constant. A to 0 is 1, so that means that the slope, m, is the logarithm of a. Therefore, the equation of the line is y minus y0, so y minus 1, is equal to m, so the logarithm of a, multiplied by x minus x0, which is 0. So y minus 1 is the logarithm of a times x. So y is the logarithm of a times x plus 1. So for the natural logarithm, the equation of the tangent line at x is 0 is that, and for the natural exponential is that, for a non-natural exponential it's this. And then for which values of a in the previous part will the tangent line at x equal to 0 have slope 1? Well, the slope is the logarithm of a. So what's being asked for is we want to solve the equation. We want to solve the equation logarithm of a is equal to 1. And the way that you do that is you keep a on its side and keep 1 on its side. And then when logarithm changes sides from left to right, on the left-hand side it's logarithm, on the right-hand side it's exponential. So a is the exponential of 1. Of course, we usually write that in this way, exponential of 1. So a is e. Therefore, the answer to part C is that the only a is the natural number e. In fact, that's a characterization of the natural exponential. It is it's the only exponential that has slope 1 at input 0, and it is the only function at all that is its own derivative, and also has slope 1 at input 0.